Welcome back to the channel. In this video, I'm going to tell you, in fact, show you with real-time examples, the sample interview questions that you can expect during Python interview. And if you are new or if you have already taken any interview for a data scientist role, the number of rounds generally differs company to company. But irrespective of that, which company you go, the very first round after the preliminary round would be your testing of Python. So if it's a role for the data scientist, the testing will be for the package Pandas. In Pandas, especially DataFrame. The interviewer is always interested to first go level by level to understand your skill sets. And if you are a false candidate, then they prefer to remove the candidate in the very preliminary stage before actually going to the hard level. So the very first interview can be you can be given a real-time or a dummy data set and in form of some CSV file, and you would be asked to perform the operations to answer a certain questions using Pandas. So although Pandas is very, very important package, and in that especially DataFrame is very important. And if you have ever realized, DataFrames have a number of operations. Of course, the interviewer cannot test all of the operations in the given time frame. However, he will always try to test your certain skill sets. And by that, I mean a certain methods, which are very crucial part of the DataFrame operations. If you know those questions, it's most likely you know DataFrame very well. So what are those important functions? That's what I'm going to discuss with you with real-time data, as I said, in this video. If you can just understand those functions in detail, it's as good as the interviewer will believe you. And in fact, you'll have a broader understanding of how to use DataFrame extensively. Coming to the agenda of this video, I'm going to make you familiar with the question types and Pandas, as I said in the beginning of the video. Second, I'm going to take 5 to 6 questions related to the data that I have taken here. This is again, as I can remind you, is a real-time time series data. And these questions are framed such that we can work with all important 4 to 5 functions that's very important in Pandas and data frame related operations. So I'm going to illustrate the various operations at a group level using group by operations such that aggregation, transformation, and also I would try to give you an understanding of which is important at what point of time and how would you can understand that. Right, I will also help you to get an idea about merging of the data frame, sorting, etc. Because the question may not be directly asking you to merge the data frames or to sort the data frames or perform renaming of your columns, but indirectly there will be a part involved to it and you have to really identify that and then solve the problem. The great part with data frame is that you can do much of these operations with just 1 or 2 line of codes, that's why making data frame a very popular data structure. Then doing all these operations will be more or less related to SQL queries. If you are new to SQL queries, I must say you must learn it as a data scientist or to work as a data scientist. Now, SQL and Python have become one of the top desired skills for a data scientist profile. However, if you already know SQL and if you want to learn and perform similar operations using Pandas, then again, I'm going to show you with examples how each of these operations or manipulation that you perform on data frame is related to which command of SQL. And let me tell you, it is important for you to identify that. The reason is in few of the interviews, it may not be saying you directly to perform SQL operations. They can just give you a data set and can say, okay, just write the code using any of the favorable language that you know. So same thing if you try to do with SQL, it's possible that you'll not have the SQL setup in your system. But if you try to do, given that you understand the relationship between data frame and SQL, if you do it on your system, given that you already have Anaconda installed, you can do those operations very easily with the data frame. Right, let's quickly start with the question set itself. So before doing that, for this exercise, you must have Anaconda installed in your system, and you can use then either Spider or Jupyter Notebook or Jupyter Lab or VS Code or PyCharm, up to you. Then I have imported here the required packages that would be required for this exercise that we are going to do. If you are really going to follow the questions and their solutions, trust me, it's 99% guaranteed you are going to qualify for the interviews that will be based on data frame. Okay, so I have loaded my data set here, which is in form of a CSV file, and that I have done using Pandas read underscore CSV method. You must be familiar with this API or any other API. In fact, Pandas provides a lot more APIs to directly read the data from your database. So be familiar with that also, because it's most likely the interviewer may ask you that question, not maybe this in this round, but some other round at the higher level. Okay, let's come to the data set that I have. This data set has many records. I'm just displaying right now here top 5 records for your reference and to get familiar with what this data is all about. If you can quickly have a glance over through the columns name, you can make out it's representing sales data for various customers and of course collected at different date. And each of this record collected is certainly related to some order. And then there is of course some line of business. Now, this is what I said, but it really, if you have to understand and if you have to say it as a story, what this means, how can we relate to it? That can be a question. So this says, okay, look, this is a business where there can be an user, and an user can place any number of orders, maybe on the same day or maybe on the different day. Every order will be unique in itself, and none of the two users will have two, say, sharing the same order ID, because order number is going to be always unique. Second, an order date, it's a date, a valid date, as you see, in form of your month, date, and year. Line of business. Line of business here, it represents nothing but the various platform. For example, a company can have a website where you can place an order, or a company can also have their app. So a user can also place an order through the app. So a company can also be receiving orders from third-party website. So that is, these are nothing but line of business. Through various channels, company is able to collect orders, and this is what the line of business actually means. And then of course, every order will have certain cells attached to it. So for every order, what is the cell that is important? Now, having understood all this, the question is, so how can I frame it? What is the relationship between each of the record here? So just always keep in mind that a user can place any number of orders within the same day, and it can be related to either same line of business or different line of business. You have to always understand. For example, a user, let's say, who is using our Amazon website, can let on the very same day, it's possible one item the person can go ahead and order from the website, Amazon website, and the second order from the Amazon app. So within a day, an user can use both of the channels. And the important thing is here, the order generated from app and from the website will be different, although the user will be same. So this is the whole hierarchy of the data. If you have understood and followed me correctly at this point, and if you can visualize the chaining of the data, the relationship between of a user with an order and date and channels, that is what is much required for you to answer further of the questions. In the next segment, I'm going to show you the list of the questions that I have come up with on this given data set and what are the functions that we can use to solve them in just a few lines of code.